Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Marian Apparition, the supernatural appearance of the Blessed Virgin Mary to a person or persons, seers, who relate a message focused on specific Christian ideals for the needs of a particular place and time. Welcome to this three-part series on Marian apparitions. Before we explore specific Marian apparitions, let's define some terms. Public revelation versus private revelation. Public revelation is God's revelation to all mankind, brought to completion in Jesus Christ, who is the fullness of revelation, and as such, we should not expect any new public revelation. This public revelation is preserved in the deposit of faith. Catholics are bound to believe the deposit of faith, which is found in sacred scripture and sacred tradition, and was handed down to us from the apostles and safeguarded by the magisterium, the teaching authority of the Church. The Catechism of the Catholic Church puts it thus: God has said everything in His Word. In many and various ways, God spoke of old to our fathers by the prophets, but in these last days He has spoken to us by a Son. Christ, the Son of God made man, is the Father's one, perfect, and unsurpassable word. In Him He has said everything. There will be no other word than this one. St. John of the Cross, among others, commented strikingly on Hebrews. In giving us His Son, His only word, for He possesses no other, He spoke everything to us at once in this sole word, and He has no more to say. Because what He spoke before to the prophets in parts, He has now spoken all at once by giving us the all who is His Son. Any person questioning God or desiring some vision or revelation would be guilty not only of foolish behavior, but also of offending Him, by not fixing his eyes entirely upon Christ, and by living with the desire for some other novelty. There will be no further revelation. The Christian economy, therefore, since it is the new and definitive covenant, will never pass away, and no new public revelation is to be expected before the glorious manifestation of our Lord Jesus Christ. Yet even if revelation is already complete, it has not been made completely explicit. It remains for Christian faith gradually to grasp its full significance over the course of the centuries. Private revelation, on the other hand, is basically any other revelation which has taken place since the New Testament, like Marian apparitions and associated messages, which can be helpful in orienting people back to Christ at specific moments in history. Catholics are not bound to believe any private revelation. In fact, if the Church has not yet approved a private revelation, the faithful should be very careful when approaching such revelations. If the Church has condemned a private revelation, it is best to stay away completely. And if the Church does approve a private revelation, it means the Church has deemed it worthy of belief, but not necessary to believe. The Catechism puts it thus: throughout the ages, there have been so-called private revelations, some of which have been recognized by the authority of the Church. They do not belong, however, to the deposit of faith. It is not their role to improve or complete Christ's definitive revelation, but to help live more fully by it in a certain period of history. Guided by the magisterium of the Church, the sensus fidelium knows how to discern and welcome in these revelations whatever constitutes an authentic call of Christ or His saints to the Church. Christian faith cannot accept revelations that claim to surpass or correct the revelation of which Christ is the fulfillment, as is the case in certain non-Christian religions, and also in certain recent sects which base themselves on such revelations. Approval of Marian apparitions falls primarily on the bishop of the place in which the alleged apparitions have occurred. If a bishop approves it, it is approved for the entire church. Rarely does the Holy See intervene, but it can at any time, with or without the bishop. And even more rarely does the Holy See overturn a bishop's determination, but it has in the past. In 1978, the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith published guidelines to help bishops in making these determinations. Norms of the Congregation for Proceeding in Judging Alleged Apparitions and Revelations, simply known as Normae Congregationis. Originally, it was not made public, as it was intended to be a document only for bishops. Excerpts were widely available, however, especially with the advent of the internet, and ultimately the full text was published by the CDF in 2012. In it, bishops are encouraged to intervene promptly if an alleged supernatural event begins to gather a following, and especially if there is danger to the faithful, such as clear doctrinal errors. The bishop can also decide never to open an investigation, and just approve an associated devotion without judging the supernatural character of the apparition, as is the case with Our Lady of Mount Carmel and the Brown Scapular. Traditionally, St. Simon Stock is said to have had a vision of the Virgin Mary, in which she gave him the brown scapular. The story seems to have developed long after his death, but regardless of whether such apparition occurred, the Church has continued to approve devotion to Our Lady of Mount Carmel, a long-standing Carmelite title for Our Lady, and the devotional wearing by the lay faithful of the brown scapular, an outer garment of the Carmelite habit. But if a bishop does want to investigate and make a judgment, here are the criteria. The events must have factually occurred. The seers must be mentally sound, sincere, morally upright, obedient to church authority, and able to return to normal practices of the faith, like Mass and receiving the sacraments. The messages must be theologically accurate. They cannot go against the deposit of faith. The fruits produced must be spiritually positive, such as prayers, conversions, and an increase of charity. Once an investigation is completed, here are three possible judgments a bishop can make. A positive judgment of constat de supernaturalitate, which means it is clearly supernatural and worthy of belief. A neutral judgment of non constat de supernaturalitate, which means it is not clearly supernatural. It does not merit condemnation per se, but it cannot be approved. And a negative judgment of constat de non supernaturalitate, which means it is clearly not supernatural and condemned as not worthy of belief. And now that we've defined some terms, in the next video we'll look at some of the most popular Marian apparitions which have enjoyed widespread veneration through liturgical celebration.
Domine Deus, Rex Caelestis.